Give me the sign, Jay.
Good, you're good to go.
Really?
Yes.
Hey, good morning, everybody.
Morning.
Hi, good morning. Good morning. Welcome to FOOF. Welcome to our fellowship. Before we start, I want us to acknowledge that we stand here today on the native traditional land of the first people of Florence, the Saisal Indians. We honor with gratitude the land itself and the members of the Saisal tribe, past, present, and future. Thank you. Yeah, that's a good one. So we're going to open our service today with singing Spirit of Life. I ask that you stand as you are able. The words are in the program, or it is number 123. The words are in the program, or 123 in the hymnal if you'd like to join us. Spirit of Life, Jeff, take it away. Developed that I don't know about. Hesitate to say what that might be. So I'm looking around. I wonder if we have any guests here for the first time. But everybody kind of looks normal. Even Lynn. Lynn's normal. She's been here a couple times. So this is a good thing. We'll just move right on. So inside the program is a reminder to remain masked while indoors, unless you're standing behind the screen. When we use our handheld microphone, we have wipes, so you can wipe off the handheld microphone if you so choose to use that during Josie's concerns. And we want to do everything we can to maintain a safe and respectful facility, okay? So if you're sitting too close to somebody and you need more room, move your chair. Just, if you want to get closer, Ashley, Diana, move your chairs. So upcoming events, you can see in the program. We've got a couple of hikes we're taking, a fog hike to Eel Lake on the 18th, and on the 25th going to Baker Beach. So if you're interested in taking a wonderful stroll through these fabulous areas, meet here at FOOF at 10 a.m. Next week we have a Sunday message from Reverend Elizabeth Mount, and Dean Schrock is here on the 24th from noon to 4 if you'd like counseling. He provides that by appointment only. And Course of Miracles and Soul Matters class coming up at the end of the month. So those are the two things coming up that I would hope you would be interested in doing. Remember, the Course in Miracles and Soul Matters class, as well as Donna's class today, are all free. We provide that for you, so you can come and be a part of our fellowship at no cost to you. So at the end of the service today, we invite you to join Donna for a dialogue circle. We can either move chairs up front here, or we have chairs in the room next door. So we can do one of two things, okay? Catherine is here to do spiritual mind treatment in our library. And then at 11:30, Donna's got a special class she's going to share with us today, starting at 11:30. I'll be there, and I look forward to it. It's about raising consciousness. So please come and join Donna at 11:30 and let her share with you these wonderful exercises. This is series one, starting today, going to focus on heart-brain coherence. Right? Gotta get it together. So at this point, I would invite Rayma, but she's not here, so you've got another announcement. Yes, you do. What's your announcement? Come on. Come on, Zanna. And while you're up here, you can light the chalice one. Just say.
I can multitask.
Ah, yeah, you can. Okay.
Okay, mask on or off over here?
On.
I'm so confused.
You can come over here and talk right here if you want.
Well, it's not that big a deal.
Yes, it is.
I actually it is a big deal because we need greeters starting August 29th. We're good until then, but please sign up to be a greeter. Okay, you see how easy it was because I did it this morning, you know? Get to say hi to everybody, welcome them, get to know people that way. So please sign up to be a greeter. I have put my name and phone number at the bottom in case something happens and you can't do it. You can call me last minute and then you get to see my smiling face again, probably. Or I will find someone to sub for you if you, so it's, you know, it's not life and death, folks. Just, it's a good way to give back to the church and it's a lot of fun. So do it. There will be other clipboards later. More clipboards to come. We're fully open. We need volunteers and that's my job now. Big shout out to Karen, who carried on the duties that she was doing this before because I was gone. I'm back, and I might get annoying about it.
So, moral of the story is sign up now. Meet new friends, sign up now. So would you like to light our chalice? I think the little clicker is over there behind, right here, right behind something. Do you see it?
Yeah.
Okay. On the outside, right there, where your finger is. There you go. Push. Pull.
See, it's not just me.
No.
No, it's not just you, Ashley. I wish it were.
We're all lighter-handed.
So these words come from Viktor Frankl. Between stimulus and response, there is a space. In that space is our power to choose our response. In our response lies our growth and our freedom. Blessed be. So what is intention? It has been defined as a purpose, a design, an objective, an end that you would like to accomplish or attain. The origin of intention is from the Latin word intentus, which literally means to stretch out, to lean forward. It means to go beyond where you are at the moment in thought, purpose, even manifestation. It means to grow and evolve. I found this also in 17th century English law. It's defined as a state of mind with respect to intelligent volition. Mm-hmm. Smart people have intentions. So that's our theme for this month, is intentions, and Donna's talk will talk about that particular aspect. But I invite Catherine to come forward as we do our joys and concerns, and I'll gladly drop some shells.
Please do. Please do. She's very thoughtful.
I'm going to pass this
Good
around.
Morning, everyone.
Thank you.
Good morning.
This is the time we expand our sphere of healing consciousness to include all those in our community in need, and to celebrate with those who raise us in joy. We all have that capacity to take our thoughts of concern, comfort, and peace, and joy for each other, and consciously bring them into our heart space, our caring capacity, and speak and act from there. It is one of the simplest spiritual practices we can do to transform a situation. So I have three shells. Start with one, please thank you. Ann Lathrop's partner, David, had a stroke at 2:30 Saturday morning. He is coming home from the hospital today. He is cognizant, but cannot walk. His will is still strong as he insists on continuing to write his online newsletter. However, he will now officially enter in-home hospice and chemo treatments will be suspended. That's one more. So she wanted two for that. Sorry, two shells. One for the hospice, two. And a third shell for Anne. She sends her sincere gratitude to Foof and all that it means to her. We love you, Anne. We absolutely love you. Yes. Mm-hmm. Continued healing thoughts for Marcia Phillips and Marcia and Colin. You know about that. It's just a continuing story. And one more for Jean Hunter, who hurt her back. That's why Zanna just jumped into action this morning at the last minute by my phone call. Swift recovery, Jean, swift recovery. Anyone else have anything they need to say?
I have a microphone. Okay. You want to come stand up front?
Oh, that's all right.
Camera.
Oh, camera. Well, this is a joy. I don't know. I don't think any of you have ever been to Hovel de Mills, but I managed to sell it and without any difficulty whatsoever, and was able to dump the money straight into Joni's house. And instead of having to wait for almost 30 years to pay it off, that'll mean 15.
All right.
And so by the time she's ready to retire, her house is going to be paid for.
Excellent.
Wonderful.
Excellent.
Great. I like those kinds of joys.
I just wanted to, I didn't get up here during announcements, sorry, Sally, announce that on Sunday, August 29th, we are going to do a new member orientation after the service here for anybody who's interested. And then on Sunday, September 19th, we will actually do the induction for new members. Excuse me. So if you're thinking about joining or want just curious and want to find out lots of interesting information about FOOF, please come and join us on the 29th.
Thank you. Okay.
Thank you. Some of you new people, I'm Little Don, and my former partner, we were known as Don and Don. He was Big Don, I was Little Don. I'm asking for prayers and a shell. His grandniece, they're twins. We've been with those two kids since they were born, and they just turned 17 3 days ago, and Friday night, Trinity tried to take her life, hang herself, and she's now in a coma. She was airlifted to one of the major cities in Wisconsin. I probably have to go back there. We're hoping she'll pull through, but now she's in a coma. We don't know the best results, but I need your prayers and support. Thank you.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Mm-hmm.
I did it.
Mm-hmm. Anybody else?
One more show, Sally. For all those we don't know about, for everyone going through transitions of whatever dimension, but also for those who are sitting in peace and comfort, because we need you too. You raise us all in your joy. I'll finish with a quote from my favorite metaphysician, Ernest Holmes. We could give of ourselves in love and service to others in a spirit of generosity and good fellowship. Real giving is the givingness of ourselves. We could do that. A kind word, a thoughtful act, perhaps just a smile can help lighten the burden of others. I live and move and act as a healing agent in the world. Blessed be. Thank you. And blessings to all that we've acknowledged here today. You all are very important to us. We love you, and we send our thoughts your way. So as we continue, we're going to open up our hymnals to hymn number 347. It's called Gather the Spirit. And Jeff's going to play it. We're going to sing it. If there's anybody out there that would like to come behind this microphone and lead us in this and sing it, if not, we're going to kind of all just follow Jeff's music, right? So, number 347, Gather the Spirit. Please stand as you are able, and let's sing this wonderful song.
There are pauses in between each verse, so
did you say applause or a pause?
The Spirit of morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I am so excited to see you all again. And it's cool over here. I love it. I love it. I love it.
It's hot where you are.
Thank you. I appreciate it very much. So this morning, I want to talk about the power of intention. Now, there's a source of life, a consciousness. We call it mind, divine mind. We call it spirit, source, creator. We call it a lot of different names, but there's only one. Now, this intelligent, wise source desired to express itself, and it began to create what we may call the souls. We may call ourselves a soul. We may call ourselves an individuated expression of that source. But we, as those souls, have the same creative power. We have been given free will to create. Desire is the basis of all creation. From the way of mastery, desire is the energy that brings forth all waves of creation. Without desire, look around. Not only would you see nothing, there would be nothing to do the seeing. Everything is the effect of desire. Now, divine mind is the consciousness or the awareness of life. We are one with this divine mind and have the same creative ability. There is no separation, there is only oneness. Therefore, that must be so. Now, there is a creative process. It is mind, idea, expression. So from the mind, which is the consciousness, comes desires. We can also call them creative ideas or creative thoughts. Our imaginations are very active in this process. Our imagination can be thought of as the partner of desire. Now, expression, so we've got mind, idea. Now, the expression is the manifestation or the realization of those creative ideas and thoughts, the desire. Here is where action is needed in that expression part. So this whole process, mind, idea, expression, can stay right there in your mind for as long as you want. You can use your imagination to see within your mind the manifestation even. And yet you can stop the manifestation of the desire into the outer. So how many of us have latent desires still within the mind and not being acted upon or being expressed? I think everybody could raise their hand on that one. Yes, I have this wonderful CD of Calypso music. And I asked my husband, he's not with us anymore, but I asked him if he would take dancing lessons with me. And I had this vision, we'd take these dancing lessons, I'd be all dressed, you know, in these beautiful, brilliant colors with matching shoes. He would be in these tight black pants, you know, with these ruffled white shirts. And he said, no. He said, I'm not going to dress like that. So, what I did instead was I would be driving down the road playing that CD and in my mind doing all of that. Down to seeing the clothes and the people clapping because we were dancing so well. Ah, yes. Mind, idea, expression. But it was still in my mind. It takes intention to follow through and to create the living experience in the physical. Desire in time, in the third dimension, is cultivated through the power of intention. So we utilize time to cultivate our desires through intentions. Now, I never went any further with that vision in my mind. Had I truly wanted it, I would have intentionally taken dancing lessons and found another partner to dance with. Okay, I could have done that, but I did not. And sometimes I wish I had, because when I play that in DOCD today, I think, oh, missed experiences there.
Not too late.
I know. So every one of us is in this creative process every moment of our lives. We're usually not aware of it. Sometimes we are, but we're usually not aware of it because it's usually in our subconscious. So today I want to talk to you about the process of how you can create consciously. Now in Unity we say we're either creating or we're miscreating. So in other words, when we are creating, we are intentionally coming from our wisdom and our intelligence, from our heart, from love. We are miscreating if we are coming from fear. You're still creating when you're in fear, but you're miscreating. That's what we say in Unity. So what intention is not? It is not the same as holding a strong egoic and willed commitment to making something happen. Intention does not mean putting your nose to the grindstone and not taking no for an answer. That's not what it is. Intention is cultivating your thought processes, the art of remembering who you are and why are you here. Okay, that's what intention really is. So it means to take those desires and passions. We all have passions, and find the ways to express them in your life and in the world, not from a place of fear, but a place of wisdom and intelligence and peace. From the Way of Mastery, it reads, intention is that energy or that use of the mind that creates through consistent practice, the channel through which desire begins to move down and re-educate the emotional body and even the cellular structure of the physical body and all of the lesser avenues of thinking that occur within the intellect. So everything involved in your being is integrated, working together and focused on the fulfillment of that one grand desire to accept your function in this world. Wow, all of that through your intentions. So I think you can see how powerful intention is in creating your life experiences. However, fear can stop intention in its tracks, can't it? Yes. Marianne Williamson wrote, in A Return to Love, our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. Yeah. Yes. We have trouble expressing our greatness, don't we? What would others think? Who cares? So we must release the fear of being powerful. Not powerful over anyone or over anything, but the power that is innate within you, that divine creature that you are, that magnificent creature that you are, that is the power that we're talking about. Now that power is already within us. In fact, it is who we are. You can say consciousness, you can power, all those things are interchangeable. So, excuse me. And there seems to be, for some reason, this trend to become enlightened. Have you heard of that? Yeah, I want to become enlightened. Well, here's my take on that I just want to offer. You are already enlightened. You were created as an enlightened being. All we have to do is remember that. So you see how great you already are? I love that. It makes me smile when I think, oh yeah, I'm great. So anyway, I want to share with you also something from the Way of Mastery that I love. It says that we are God remembering God. Okay, Okay, so we are those magnificent creations, remembering who we are, one with God. Now, as those powerful beings, if you can imagine, whatever you decree is. And you say, well, that doesn't sound right. But we do it every day. Every moment of our lives, we are decreeing our experience, and we're doing it through that very same creative process. So why not create with intentions that are created from our wisdom, from our passions, from our hearts, from our love, from, you know, those wonderful, I call them life-enhancing emotions and desires and intentions. Because you know what we do? We take life too seriously. Start thinking about life as fun. I call my life an adventure. An adventure. And I go on a lot of adventures, and I love them. Now, as I shared last time with you, 95% of our awareness is subconscious, okay? And that subconscious is running our lives in more ways than you can ever imagine. And that's something that we really need to work on. But I truly believe, and it has worked for me, it doesn't work every time, but I'm aware of this process, and it works when I take that process and actually use it. But when we begin to change those subconscious influences, we do it through conscious intention. That is how we can change those subconscious intentions or whatever it is in there. I don't even know what's in there. But we can change whatever's in there by using our conscious intention process. And it works. It works. I know I've released several things, and I realize that as I've gone through and used this process. Now, this means that you use your courage to hold on to those intentions by thinking, saying, and doing all the things that will support those intentions. In other words, when you do that, I do believe they will override the subconscious. They will come up. You know, that subconscious stuff will come up, and that's really good. Because when it comes up, you look at it and you say, you have no more power over me, and you let it go. It's gone. So it's good that it comes up. Don't be afraid of that. Let it come up. Now, this is something I really want you to hear. Efforting is the antithesis of creation. I looked up the word efforting. It's one of those, and this is how they described it, a new difficult word. But it's a good word. I like that word. So what that means is you want to hold on to your intention with wisdom and with grace, okay? In other words, this is an experience of being in the flow, okay? Not trying to force anything, just being with it, being in the flow, and it will happen. Because creation is flow. It's not effort, it's flow. And when we really understand that, your life will change. It will be a flowing life, and you will be amazed, truly amazed. When I met my tandem instructor, Emmanuel, I knew that I was in the flow, and my intention to skydive was going to be a beautiful creation. And it was, because you know what? Emmanuel in Hebrew means God is with us. I think that was the best sign I could get. And I tell you, the moment I heard that, all fear was gone. I had an adventure that was indescribable. And I just want to prove that I did it. Just in case you thought I was pulling your leg. But it was truly a wonderful experience. I call them adventures, like I said. Now, sometimes our intentions are to change someone else, or some event, or some situation. And we really get involved, and we try so hard to make it the way we want it to be. Well, a very wise being once said, sometimes doing nothing can lead to the very best of something. Who said that? Winnie the Pooh. Now you remember, don't you? All right, well, I am learning just that. Sometimes when I want things to be the way I want them to be, if I just step back, you know, they take care of themselves, and they did not need me at all. I'm not advocating here that we do nothing. That's not at all what I'm saying. Because at other times, I am guided by my intuition, which tells me this is mine to do in this situation. So the difference here is being in the flow, listening to your guidance, and then doing what is yours to do. Not trying to do things to make them the way you want them. Because you know what? We don't know. We really don't know. And that's why I want to tell you that this is all about you and your intentions. We are not here to fix anyone else. In fact, we have a really big job trying to fix ourselves. It's huge. You know, that's why in our Power of Eight, and I know you have one here, which is wonderful, but in our Power of Eight, we ask for the intentions to come from the person who wants the intention. And sometimes we really want to change the wording on that intention, but we don't, okay? We don't. We have to honor their words, their intention, because we do not know what is the best thing for them. And then when we have, you know, intentions that we want to hold for children or pets, or maybe events in the world, you know, those that cannot give you an intention, we hold an intention for their highest and best. And that's just as powerful. We're still asking for their highest and best. And we're also saying, we do not know what that is. So, as your intentions are expressed for you and from you, the world will see that and it will respond. Because the world is a reflection of our collective consciousness. And each one of us is a very important part of that collective consciousness. So everything that you do, that you hold in grace and wisdom for you, reflects out to everyone else. So be aware of what you're thinking, saying, and doing at all times. Be aware of what you are attaching to your I am. Because what follows are your intentions for you. I am is the expression of who you think you are. So what are you attaching to those words? Are you empowering yourself or disempowering yourself? You know, the universe will support you. All of your intentions, whether you are creating or miscreating, because of free will. I have this vision, the universe cries when we're miscreating. But we have free will. We can do it if we want. So if you know, if you're experiencing an illness, you say that my body is experiencing cold right now, but it has no power over me. In my truth, I am healthy and whole. Now your body will let go of that cold a lot quicker than if you're sitting there saying, I am sick, you know? You see the difference? I am healthy and whole, and boom, okay, let's get you healthy and whole. Now, you may say, people don't talk that way. And I say, I know. They don't talk that way. Every day, I hear disempowering words attached to people's I am. And actually, it's very sad. So we must get over this if we are to be in control of our lives and create our lives that we truly want. And when you do that, you are a wonderful power for the world. Now, the main point of my message for you today is that you have the power to make and change your life through your intentions, even in today's chaos. And many extremes, isn't it? We keep going up and down with this thing. But I urge you to think about this and to consciously create your intentions I always check my intentions to make sure that they are not trying to make someone else or something else different. This is all about you, remember. So keep your intentions for you. And choose intentions that keep you healthy and strong and happy and joyful. You know, choose intentions that will help bring peace in the world through you. So every loving intention not only will affect and enhance your life, but it touches everyone else. And it will make a huge, huge difference in the world, because it will help bring that harmony to our world, our communities. And I encourage you to write down your intentions. Think about them daily. Know them, feel them, taste them if you want to taste them, you know, because then they will manifest much faster. And I also encourage you to go into the wisdom of your heart. I'm going to actually talk a lot about that today in class. The law of the universe is that if you give it clear intentions, it will support you all the way. But if you don't have clear intentions, the universe doesn't know what to do for you. So that's why it's very important that you have very clear intentions. So I want to close with this quote from The Way of Mastery. Likewise, look upon your creations and marvel. How is it that you could abide in this time frame on this planet? That is a mystery and a marvel, and no one knows how it is done. Yet it is done. The reason it is done is that all power has been given unto you, and what you decree is. A man or a woman shall decree a thing, and it shall be so. You have decreed this moment. Own it. For by owning it right now, you can begin to sense the incredible and awesome power that flows through you in each moment. And it is the power to create. You and you alone are the creators of your life. So now I want to invite you to join me with a short meditation. And then Jeff is going to play for us. So we'll move right into that. So I invite you to close your eyes and just get very comfortable in your seat. And as you close your eyes, just let everything be. And feel how safe you are in this precious moment. Celebrate your innate freedom to think, to feel, and to be anything you choose. Open yourself to the experience of your boundless nature and connect with the freedom that is your birthright. Create your life from your wisdom and grace by expressing your intentions. And in those moments when life just doesn't seem to be reflecting your intentions, let us remind ourselves of these words from The Rose. Just remember, in the winter, far beneath the bitter snows, lies the seed that with the sun's love in the spring becomes the rose. Jeff. Oh,
are two acts that are hard to follow. I have to confess, I was a little anxious today that we might run over on time and force you all to sit here longer than you need to, and man, was I wrong. Everything we did today was with the intention of bringing the perfect message and the perfect music. And may I also say, those who did not come to the Starlight Cabaret this past Friday really missed some exceptional music from Jeff Lovejoy. So thank you, Jeff, for today and for Friday as well. Thank you. Okay, Donna, you got me some things to think about. I'm going to invite two of you to come forward. He's our other wonderful musician who shares his gift with us on the days that Jeff is not here, and vice versa. So we, at this time, have our offering. And each week we talk about offering to this particular fellowship through your pledge payment or contribution. And we also talk about our commitment to our community. And every couple of months, we have a new community partner. And this community partner, through this month, we will conclude with raising money for the program called Food Backpacks for Kids. Now, my buddy Tuvia, he loves to share with you exactly what it means to donate money to our community partners in general and as a whole. So I invite Tuvia to come forward and talk about community giving.
It's just hard not to say something about, I'm just in tears, how beautiful this morning is, and sitting among friends and everything. But there's been no time in the history of our congregation when the Community Partners Program has been so important, accelerated by both the pandemic and global warming, which is bringing severe food and housing shortages. I have a little message, and it's going to be placed into the FOOF blast, and at any time, if there's any questions or anything, please don't hesitate to contact me. I would like to say something now about those 110 children. We are in the second month of giving, and they need our help to ensure food to eat. That's what Backpacks for Kids is all about. So let's rally our hearts and our conscience to put food into hungry stomachs, and know that your donation relieves the pain of hunger. If you are in a position where you can spare a little cash to alleviate the suffering of those children, please do it. Thank you.
So we have the way of doing that, and that is to pass the ever-popular baskets, right? We're a Unitarian Universalist Fellowship, and we believe in clipboards and baskets. Yes, we do. So the inner basket is for food backpacks for kids. It says that right here. The other one is for this particular fellowship. And I wanted to say something about that. It's pretty remarkable, the amount of gifts that we give here at this particular fellowship. And if you're listening to this at home and you can't drop some funds in here, please know that you can go to our website, anyone here as well, florenceuuf.org.
Yeah. She's looking for reassurance and not getting any.
florenceuuf.com. Anyway, our website. You can click on the donate button and express your interest in donating to our community partner and or to this particular fellowship. So as we move forward with our offering, I'm going to ask, maybe Darlene, would you help on this side? And Catherine, would you help on this side as the basket comes around? As we move forward, I ask that you repeat after me. Divine love through me.
Divine love through me.
Blesses and multiplies all that I am.
Blesses and multiplies all that I am.
All that I give.
All that I give.
And all that I receive.
And all that I receive.
I am prosperous now.
I am prosperous now.
Blessed be.
Blessed be.
Okay. And Jeff's going to play a little music, and we continue. Good kids. appreciation. So, Brooke, would you like to extinguish our chalice? These words come from Brian Keeley, titled Carry the Flame. The chalice is now extinguished, but its light lives on in the minds and hearts and souls of each one of you today. Carry that flame with you as you leave this place and share it with those you know, with those you love, and most especially, with those you have yet to meet. Donna has some closing words she'd like to share. I have them written down here if you want to read them. Come on up. You said you wanted to read them. I know, I got you down here as part of my program. We can't get enough of her, right?
Okay, where is it? Oh, I see. Intentions are gateways, and they require action. Without the action energy, even our best intentions get swept under the rug or carried out with the shifting winds. You create your intentions with every thought, every moment. Be aware of those intentions and keep the ones that reflect your passion. Intention is direction. Which way are you walking?
So as we conclude, remember Donna will be right up here to do a dialogue circle. It's fun to sit around and chit-chat about the message and what it meant for you. And we'll be here shortly thereafter, 11:30 at the latest. We'll gather for Donna's class. And by a show of hands, we've not had many people wanting to use the backyard anymore, so we've not really unlocked it. Unless there's a dying need that you all have to go gather in the backyard with lunch or anything else, then we'll probably keep the backyard locked up. But you do have the space here if you'd like to stay around and chit-chat or go outside and take your mask off and have a good time. I said that out loud. You can get rowdy out there, but a little more subdued inside here. Anyway, we're going to try something new in honor of protecting everybody as best we can with this COVID. We're going to ask that you rise and stay in place. We're going to sing our peace song. If you're with somebody you love, you want to hold hands, please go for it. If not, we're just going to rise. We're going to sing our peace song. The words are on the back of the program. You can follow along to Jeff's music. And then, peace song. Thank you, Jeff.